Welcome to Unite Now, where we bring unity to you, wherever you are.
All right. This is First on Stadia, how two indies built Get Packed with Unity. My name is Lukas. Previously, I have shipped games on nearly all platforms, PC, console, mobile, and even VR. I'm one of the senior programmers here at Coatsink. We're an indie development company and publisher, and we've partnered with Moonshine Studios to co-develop and publish Get Packed. Get Packed is a couch co-op removals game full of calamity and physics-based carnage. It's got 1-4 player local and online co-op with campaign and destruction game modes. Of course, it makes a lot more sense if I just show you, so here's the trailer. First, I'll be talking about why we chose to release on Stadia, and why Unity was the best way to do that. Then I'll go a little bit deeper into how Get Packed was built in Unity, which tools we used for it, and why we found them useful. And then I'll dive into the Stadia-specific stuff. What did it take to get the game running on Stadia, and how did we implement its various features? Last but not least, I'll tell you about an exciting new program from Google to bring more of Unity's indie games onto the Stadia platform. Real quick, this talk is intended for indie developers working in Unity or those aspiring to work in Unity. And it's meant for anyone who might want to bring their game to the Stadia platform. For those unfamiliar, Stadia is Google's brand new cloud gaming platform. There's no physical console required. All computing happens in the cloud, and it streams high-fidelity gameplay right to your screen. This is an exciting development and something we really wanted to try out. Just imagine, it's like buying a game on Steam, except there's no client to install, and you don't even need to download the game. You just click play, and it loads up immediately. And then, even on an old laptop, it'll run at 60 FPS on the highest settings. No need to buy a gaming PC or the latest console. Of course, this was uncharted territory for us. There were so many unknowns in terms of the development process and how to build for a platform like this, especially with it being in the cloud. But we had a great experience with it, especially using Unity, who had production-ready support right out of the gate, with all the tech and tools we needed to bring our vision for Get Packed to life. On top of that, seeing so many other Unity developers ready to help and share and discuss, it's such a great inspiration, and it's why Moonshine Studios decided to make their first game in Unity. So I think it's time we give something back, and I'd like to tell you our story, and hopefully it inspires you. All right, let's talk about the core Unity tools we use to create Get Packed. There are more tools in Unity than I could ever cover, so I'll specifically talk about the ones that were the most useful during the development of Get Packed. Starting with the timeline. You might already know that the timeline is great for creating cutscenes. You have lots of control over the camera, animations, and timing. But another cool application is to use it for gameplay prototyping. You might not be sure whether a new mechanic will be fun, so why not try and build it with a timeline before diving into code? And it might look a bit silly, but it can give you a quick idea of whether something will be fun. And if you think the feature might be worthwhile, you can build it out fully. And as you can see, for the forklifts, this workflow turned out great. Now, one of the most impactful systems was the prefab variant system. With prefab variants, you can make as many variations as you want from a single base prefab. For example, you could have multiple characters that behave the same but look different. When you want to make a change and apply it to all variants, you can just change the base prefab. For example, if you've changed something in the AI, that needs to be applied to all these pedestrians. And onto post-processing. One of the features in the post-processing stack is color grading, and I'll show you some examples. With just a few settings, you can make your scene look drastically different. And here's another one. These are just the result of some very simple tweaks, and you can find the post-processing stack in the package manager if you want to play with it yourself. So the FBX exporter lets you export any prefab or shape to an FBX. An artist can then open and modify this FBX file in a program like Maya and model it fully. This is a great workflow for turning blockouts into detailed shapes. So if you know you want to add a slide, for example, you can just export this part of the level, and now you can model that slide in the exact dimensions where it'll be used. And I'll show you the end result. And as always, you can find the FBX exporter in the package manager. Okay, now that we've talked about the key Unity tools we used, let's answer the main question. How do you develop for a platform like Stadia? The first thing to understand is Stadia's cloud instance system. As the game is streamed to you, it means it's running on a machine somewhere in a server farm. As a developer, you have access to these machines in the form of cloud instances. But this means that whenever you make a build, you first have to upload it there before it can run. You can do this manually through the command line interface, uploading each build file one by one, but it's much easier to automate this process, which is exactly what Unity's build and run will do for you. It's surprisingly easy to get a build up and running on Stadia. For Get Packed, it only took a couple of days. Now, there's a bunch of features on Stadia that you'll want to implement. To start with a simple one, Stadia, of course, supports achievements. Get Packed has almost 40 achievements currently, and we're adding even more soon. There's the option to use progression achievements, which show the percentage of completion, as well as, of course, normal achievements that are just immediately unlocked. Now, I want to make a quick mention about cloud saving as well. It's a feature that most platforms have, allowing players to continue with their save even on different machines, and making sure they always have a backup if anything goes wrong. But whereas it might be optional for developers to implement on some platforms, on Stadia it's actually mandatory. This is because of how the platform works. Whenever the player starts the game, it'll be running on a different cloud instance pretty much every time, so having only local saves simply wouldn't do. Now, let's talk about multiplayer and how that's implemented. Multiplayer in Get Packed works with a lobby system. You can create a lobby and then invite your friends, or use matchmaking to find others. Matchmaking is very straightforward. For the player, it's just the press of a button, and you'll see people start joining automatically. From a developer's perspective, we're essentially merging lobbies until we've got a full party, and Stadia's backend offers great support for this. If you've got friends who want to play, you can invite them through the Stadia UI. We have a button in the lobby screen that opens a Stadia pop-up menu, allowing you to quickly invite friends. It's also possible to use Shift plus Tab, which brings up the default overlay, and you can invite people that way as well. In fact, if you invite people through the default overlay while you're not in a lobby, it'll actually automatically put you in online mode and make a lobby for you, which is super handy. here's what it looks like when you get an invite. First, there's a notification at the top, and then pressing Shift plus Tab shows you the invite fully. Then you can just click Accept, and you're in. And you can accept that invite from anywhere. In fact, you can even accept an invite without having the game open. When you accept it, it'll automatically launch the game and immediately put you in that online lobby. Last but not least, let's talk about Stadia enhanced features. These are unique features not available on any other platform. Just to be clear though, these features are not currently in Get Backed, but I'll mention them in case you find them interesting. Let's start with CrowdPlay. It's a feature that integrates with YouTube streaming, allowing viewers to enter a queue in order to join a multiplayer game with their favorite streamer. We're currently looking into implementing this one for Get Backed. Crowd Choice is another feature for YouTube streaming, but here the viewers are able to influence the streamer's game by voting on polls or typing specific words in the chat. State Share lets you save a game state and share it with friends. For example, a randomly generated map or the moment right before a boss fight. And Stream Connect lets you view another player's screen in real time, which could be really cool for co-op or tactical games. And all of these features are, of course, supported by Unity. Now that you've seen everything that Stadia has to offer, you might be asking, how do I get my game on Stadia? We know how tough it can be for indies to get discovered and to get in contact with the right people. And that's why we're really excited to see Google partner with Unity and announce a new program called Stadia Makers. And it's just for experienced indie Unity developers. The program offers a lot of great benefits, including funding, free development hardware from Google, and technical assistance from Unity. They only announced this last month, and they're looking for games right now. So if you're an indie studio working on a game that ships this year, and you want to bring it to Stadia, then Stadia Makers is for sure the best way to go. You can check it out and apply at stadia.dev/apply. And that's it. So as a quick recap, we've talked about why we released on Stadia and why we chose Unity to build Get Backed. I've also shown you the Unity tools we use to develop the game, and you've seen how we integrated Get Backed with the Stadia platform. And last but not least, for indie developers that want to bring their game to Stadia, be sure to check out the Stadia Makers program. Hopefully you found this useful. If you have any additional questions, feel free to reach out to me on Twitter. Thank you for watching.